Fear not.
I know there's not much time, but I need answers.
I imagine you have many questions.
I have questions about my family.
The sentimental and emotional connections formed between people have always irked me. I knew Mirini would fail to stay detached.
Why did you come here and leave my mother and me in Sparta?
I was never going to raise you. Our duty was to continue our ancient bloodline and ensure there was someone strong enough to do what was necessary when the time came.
You could have brought us here with you.
And you would have been unprepared.
If you've been here all these years, how did you meet my mother?
We're both descendants of the people who built this place, just like you. We knew that we had an obligation to preserve our lineage.
That's when you agreed to make me.
In a manner of speaking, yes.
Why is the cult hunting our family?
It is our family's destiny to control the power in this place. In our blood lies the key to unlocking the secrets of Atlantis.
So they want our blood?
You have a destiny, my child, to destroy the cult and their influence on the Greek world. You threaten everything they have striven for, because you have the power to oppose them.
They've tried to destroy me and failed, and they'll never control me. That's all I wanted to know. I want to know more about Atlantis and your work.
There isn't enough time for me to explain even a fraction of what I have learned here. All I can offer for now is a hint of enlightenment.
You call it Atlantis, but what exactly is this place?
I believe it was a city long ago. A place where beings of great knowledge and power lived before humankind had built even its first primitive settlements. It was perhaps some kind of library where the ancient ones stored information.
This place is like a tomb. How did you live down here, and for so long?
This artifact, like your spear, possesses incredible power. It has given me life, so that I may continue to learn from this place.
What have you been studying here?
Everything. The first civilization's history, their culture, their science. With it, we can change humanity's destiny and usher in an age of enlightenment.
Destiny is something only the gods can alter.
They were gods, living, breathing gods.
I've heard enough. What do I do with the artifacts?
Just place them in their corresponding steles, and the path to answers will illuminate.
I should go.
Yes. There is much to do. Bring back the artifacts quickly. The longer we wait, the greater the risk of Atlantis being discovered. Hurry. This artifact will help us close off the temple.
You're nearly as stubborn as its former owner.
You who manipulate human progress, what do you hope to achieve? You treat humans as useful apes. How many artifacts have you created to control their minds? Do you fear their potential that much? Just look at what humans have achieved on their own. Democracy and diplomacy. A legacy of culture and art. We could share in this if you just treat them as equals. In your desperate search for immortality, you've ignored the obvious. You run endless simulations to find one in which nothing changes. It's pointless. Change will come. And not just the so-called end of the world you fear. You call yourself saviors, but tell me. Would this doomsday have appeared had you not pulled on the threads of the universe in the first place?
Well done. This artifact will bring us closer to seeing
it. It nearly brought me closer to my tombstone.
I am taking over your retransmissions. You don't speak for all of us anymore.
These people sure like building boats.
You! Come here! Come to see the richest man in Achaea, have you?
You don't look rich.
The richest person in any land is the one who wants for the least. And I want for nothing at all.
Rich? Wanting for nothing and calling me over to help? Doesn't make sense.
Ah! A mind that thinks for itself. Someone save me from this horror. Relax, relax. The name's Democritus. renowned thinker of thoughts, writer of rights, and questioner of answers.
I'm Cassandra. And I've never heard of you.
Probably says more about you than me, Cassandra. Now, you came here to help, hmm? So happens, I've uncovered the whereabouts of three divine mathematical discoveries.
Mathematical discoveries? Really?
Yes, really. The theorems, when combined with my own, will unlock the greatest mystery in the universe, which, as you know, is a place where mysteries strive to remain locked. Bring these three theorems to me, and I will reward you handsomely.
So, you get the theorems, and I get a reward. From a man who seems completely disinterested in Drachmi.
Drachmi is for idiots! What I offer is far greater than that. But first, the theorems.
Fine. What are they?
Only the greatest achievements of rational thought. The original transcriptions of the Golden Ratio, the Pythagorean Theorem, and Zeno's Paradox.
Tell me about Zeno's paradox.
Myself excluded. Zeno of Elea was the world's brightest philosopher, known for writing paradoxes that could stump anyone. His work was thought destroyed, but I happen to know the priests in Locris saved it.
About the golden ratio.
Ah, the divine number. It's a guiding principle in architecture, sculpture, and is found in nature too. The original is wasting away in the dirty hands of sculptors in Argos. It should be with a mathematician, like me.
Where am I going to find the Pythagorean theorem?
It's all around you, of course. Deceptively simple, but subtly mysterious. The equation was apparently etched in stone. I heard the tale, it was lost in sunken ruins between three islands that form a triangle.
I'll find these theorems for you.
Come back as soon as you have one.
The golden ratio. Democritus will want to know I found it. The documents Democritus wants. This isn't even math. It's a child's fable.
Thank you.
Ancient adventurer, I made this recording to try to help you. I'm sorry if it's confusing.
Waiting your orders, Commander!
Future, and I know you'll be here more than once. My fellow precursors have endless challenges in your path. Artifacts, creatures. Don't get me started on the elements.
Stay back and avoid the fight.
More speed! Battle position! We're moving now! Ready arrows! We need to use fire!
Commander, we need to brace the back out of the way!
Here it is. Thank you. Χαίρε, Δημόκριτος.
Κασάνδρα! What have you brought me?
So, I found Zeno's paradox.
You did? And what did you think of it?
The tortoise arrives at a point. Achilles, who is chasing it, runs after him. But after Achilles arrives at the same point, the tortoise has moved on. By the time Achilles arrives at the tortoise's new spot, the creature has again moved further.
Exactly. It shows how the universe divides itself infinitely.
A mathematical theory hidden in a child's fable.
Zeno was clever. Every knowledgeable old man I've ever met was an idiot. But the minds of children are endlessly wise.
I found the original golden ratio.
A discovery that will change the course of existence.
If you say so. It's just a rectangle to me.
Open your eyes. That rectangle is two shapes. A rectangle, yes, but also a square. The length of sides A and B is to the length of the side A, as A is to B.
So how can this theory be used?
Used? It isn't used, only observed. It is the divine balance occurring naturally in the most measurably beautiful places in the world. It is everywhere. And nowhere.
It took some doing, but I found the Pythagorean theorem.
The greatest breakthrough the world will ever know. And now we have it in its original glory!
I thought it might be about the points of the triangle, but the theorem is about the length of the sides.
Astute! You're wiser than you put on. The two shorter sides squared, when added together, are equal to the square of the hypotenuse.
That was a lot to take in. But I think I found everything.
You did! And with this, I can finally form my grand theory. The theory that simultaneously divides and unites all the universe.
What is this theory?
Using the theorems as evidence, I intend to prove that the universe is divisible into infinitely smaller parts. As we break reality down, the parts shrink, and the space between them grows.
Once you prove your theory, what will you do with it?
Although I aim to prove that the universe is divisible, I hope that the theory can be used to unite people.
All of this sounds ambitious.
One can't achieve greatness by attempting mediocrity. But I confess, I have a personal motivation.
Everyone always does.
Ha! In another life, you would have made a fine student. When I was a student, I loved a poet. But I was so consumed by study, I never told her. I hope to use these theorems to show her my poetry. And maybe to win her heart.
If that's what you want to do, let's do it.
What? Right now?
You missed your chance to tell her once, Democritus. There's no point in missing it again. Let's go.
You're right. This time I will do it properly.
I never would have guessed you were a lover.
Well, I wasn't. My theory that all atoms exist as a great void between them is a bit like the life I've lived.
Not anymore. Now you're filling that void.
Maybe. Maybe what fills the void and what draws us together is love.
Hello. I'll see you soon.
We should stick together, no?
Save that line for the poet, Democritus. It's a good one.
You think so? All right, I will.
The watch will be vigilant.
No! That's her! Those bandits, stop them!
Someone help me!
Democritus, I'm sorry.
They killed her. For it to end like this, after all this time.
You have your theorem, and the others. Read them to her. Let her see your poetry.
It's too late.
It's never too late.
You can go. In another life, she might have known my love for her. You might have been my student. Imagine the happiness we'd have known.
A wise man told me, the richest person in any land is the one who wants for the least. Don't want for the past, Democritus.
I'll leave soon enough. But for now, I think I want for privacy. Take this and leave me to mourn, Cassandra. Oh.
They won't ask any questions. Best keep out of sight.
You can't be here!
Please stop!
This war will rage forever, and so will the cult.
Thank you.
They'll be on high alert here. Stay hidden.
Dare defy us. My name is Podero. I am the one who will end the
Bad!
better off without you.